to STS brought to you by Useless Agent. This program is not meant to discredit anyone's social or sexual identity. You are all fair game in the eyes of the wicked, and we see you. Please grow a pair and enjoy, or stick to Fox News. Here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go.
I would go out and rob some more. We ran everything. Paid off cops. We paid off lawyers. We paid off judges. Everybody had their hands out. Everything was for the take. And now it's all over. Now it's all over. All over. All over. All over.
Welcome to Useless Agent.
Alrighty, there's my beautiful children. Alright, how's it going, chickadees, beautiful people, and my wonderful starflies? How's it going? Today is the 20th of December, and we are still going. We actually hit our one-year mark, I think about a week ago. So I had no clue that we had been doing this show that long. So thank you for... anyone that's been watching it longer than the last 4 months, I really appreciated it because I started this show at a real dark time in my life and I needed something, you know. Music was, you know, I was hitting a mental block in music and I just needed some way to vent. And the beautiful person at Spiritual Essence is a friend of mine, Ghana. She just kept hooking me up with all of this great equipment, and you know, I just decided to go with what I've been told since I was a kid by teachers, which was, you know, if you had a radio show, I actually had a teacher write this on my paper. If you had a radio station, I'd be your number one listener. My own teacher tells me that in high school. So I kind of always knew that I was good with words and my vocabulary is reasonably extensive. So I can definitely convey whatever I needed to. And then I recommend that game, My Word Coach, because it definitely helps with your vocabulary. But also as a child, I was obsessed with reading the Thesaurus. The Thesaurus was always my favorite thing to do because I loved learning new words, because to me it was like learning a whole new language, because when you speak intelligently and coherently and cohesively, there's a certain respect you instantly gain, and there's like a knowledge, there's an acknowledgement to it. So I try to, you know, really push forward with the intellectualism. All right, so speaking of anti-intellectualism, which is a bad segue. Shut up. All right. So let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and let's start with what do we got? Okay. So we're basically talking about the Latino vote somehow becoming the Latino vote for Trump is growing in the polls, and I understand the fear of it. I can totally understand the fear of it, but I do not. I didn't think that it was actually an issue. I honestly did not until I went off and did an episode on TikTok, and not an episode. I just did this little short. And as I did that, the comments were funny and really clever. But somebody had mentioned right off the bat saying, sorry, bro, Latinos are going to Trump. And that just, I mean, that it hurt. Like, it hurt. It was like a punch to the stomach. I couldn't help but feel like, what? No. We don't do that. Like, I turned into Shia LaBeouf out of nowhere. No. So I wanted to talk about what Trump calls poisoning the blood of America. Now, in this interview we're about to see, you're going to notice the gymnastics, the, you know, English gymnastics, mental gymnastics that she's going to try to use to deflect the issue. But all she's doing is just circling around the other side. I mean, she's literally just taking the other gate into the same fucking, you know, house. So, you know, it's not even like she's coming in through a window. She's just literally using the back door instead of the front. So, and I'm getting really sick of this. How does anybody fall for this shit? Like, we don't know what he's saying. He's literally going around saying, I tell it like it is. And then these fucking idiots try to tell us, oh no, he's actually more clever than you think. And he's using subtle satires and certain nomenclatures that are meant to be satirical. They're not meant to be taken seriously. You just don't get him. And I'm like, no, you don't get him. You want to believe that he gives a flying fuck about anybody but himself, but he doesn't. So let's go ahead and watch this clip and look at the amount of gymnastics she does just to say the exact same thing that she's already been asked. The question is simple.
About the Democratic policies.
He was talking about people.
Okay, well, look,
policies.
I don't
see he was talking about people.
Look, I know that some are trying to make it seem like President Trump is anti-immigrant. The reality is he was married to immigrants. He's hired immigrants. I mean, he's not. He was talking about
people coming across the border. He was
saying they're coming
that
over the border.
Mm-hmm. He was saying that they were bringing crime. They were bringing, you know, violence with them when they came
into
the country.
There we go. And it's that whole, and it's true. No, it isn't. It's not true. So as I made this video on TikTok that was talking about, you know what? It was a Trump joke. The video was just a little Trump joke, and it ended up turning into... Actually, you know what? Let's show the video. Let's show the video why I got in trouble for this shit. So, I'm going to go ahead and show you the video. Because this is what literally started this whole thing. This entire subject that I'm doing today came from this little tiny comment that ordinarily should just be very passive and ordinarily I wouldn't care, but it was more than that. It was definitely more than that, because this was showing me a reality that I was not aware of. And so, all right, so let's go ahead and show you the video that I made that I got in trouble for with these Latino Trumpers, which is just the most ridiculous, you know, oxymoron I've ever heard of. I mean, that's a serious paradox right here. So, all right. I think it's this one called Mexibam Advice. So if you go to TikTok, check out Mexibam, and that's how you can find me. It's also under Useless Agent. All right, so here's the video.
Here's something you should never say to a total...
Yeah, let me try to...
Hey, did you know that Trump is with God?
Let's go ahead and rewind that.
Here's something you should never say to a total stranger. Hey, did you know that Trump is with God and he's going to save us all? And he's totally fighting for... Here's something you should never say to a total stranger. Hey, did you know that Trump is with God and he's going to save us all? And he's totally fighting for... Here's something you should never say to
me. All right, so that was the joke. That was it. It was a very simple, plain, didn't need to try that hard to do. I thought it was funny. A few people thought it was funny. I got a few hearts for that. And, you know, I was just having fun. But immediately in the comments, I get, you know, sorry, bro, Trump for 2024, Latinos got him. And I'm like, bro, what the fuck are you talking about? Then you must be the dumbest Latino I've ever met. Because you know he calls you rapists, right? He thinks we rapists. He thinks we criminals. He thinks we're fucking psychos. And this motherfucker can't even tie his own shoes. And he has been bashing us. And not only Latino communities, but all immigrants. So when you hear that excuse, you know, oh, Trump wasn't saying that the immigrants are poisoning the blood of America. He's saying the Democrats are, by opening the border and letting in the immigrants. So in, you literally just 360'd. We didn't even turn any different direction. We're right back at, so brown people are bad, right? That's the whole point. Let's fear brown people. Because let's remember, he actually jumped into it saying, and it's not just Mexico. I'm not doing a fucking Trump impression anymore. Yeah, I probably will. It's not the people, it's the fucking, you know, he started blaming Africa. He blamed basically everything except for Europe. And of course, why would you want to talk about the UK? Isn't that where the Boston bombing guys came from? Weren't they from UK? You leave out Europe completely. But you want to talk about Central America, you want to talk about Europe, you want to talk about Asia. You basically just saying anyone that's not white Protestant. And that is it. If you watch the movie American History X, you get to understand what is, I mean, from that little line, I hate anyone that isn't white Protestant. You know, when Edward Furlong says that line, he just gave you everything you need to know about MAGA. That's exactly who they hate, whether they consider themselves Protestant or not. It's really the white part that matters. So then you got morons like Rudy Giuliani, which is a perfect segue going into Rudy, and then I shoot you fucking assholes. All right, so let's go to the next one. The next one is going to be on... Rudy literally doubling down moments after being, you know, losing a huge hundreds of millions of dollars case. You know, this is a fucking nine figures of fucking money, man. So he loses a nine-figure case and he still thinks, oh yeah, I'm gonna go on and defame them some more. So he did this, which literally led another lawsuit this morning.
In changing votes.
There's no proof of that.
Oh, you're damn right there is.
No, there's not. That's why you just lost.
So Rudy Giuliani, you see today, is the same man who cleaned up the streets of New York, took down the mafia.
Stipulation isn't proof.
Let me talk over you, because if you keep talking, you're going to get me in a lot of trouble. And I'm supposed to protect you, and I'm doing a very terrible job, which is basically what you've been doing for the last 40 years.
All right. So Rudy Giuliani, you see today is the same man.
Look how pathetic that is. Look at how pathetic that is. And he has to literally shout over Rudy, because Rudy is literally incriminating himself. He is dead on incriminating himself again. Just I swear to God, he and Trump, they're like one in the same mind. Yeah, I just lost $148 million, so I'm going to go talk shit. Like, dude, you know, first of all, there's a lot of people that claim that Ruby and Shay will never get a dime of that. That's not true if they have the right lawyer. There are different assets that you can look at that are not leaned on already. He's already got a lien on his fucking properties. He already has a you know, he's already being bankrupted. So when they say, you know, oh, she won't be able to collect a dime, no, you can actually get some of those assets, you know, if they're not already claimed. So listen to this again while I cough my nuts off for a second. I'll be right back.
And changing.
There's no proof of that.
Oh, you're damn right there is.
You're damn right there is. I just lost 100 days.
So Rudy Giuliani, you see today, is the same man who cleaned up the streets of New York, took down the mafia.
You gotta get louder.
Let's go.
This is where you need to take out the hot dog and, you know, lead him into the car. Come on, Rudy. Get in the car. Keep the mouth shut until you open it for the plane. Come on. He's a fucking moron. I mean, seriously. So far, I just showed you Trump, you know. All right, fuck it. I just showed you Giuliani going after these two black women for no other reason than, conspiracy theory bullshit that has no factual basis. There's so many real conspiracies out there that I work on and I learn about. If you caught my... I did a 2-hour stream on Columbine the other day. You can check that out on Twitch. I'm not saying that Columbine was not Eric and Dylan. I'm just saying there was a lot more than just Eric and Dylan. And some of them are still alive. not most of them. That's just how it goes. See, and that's another way to tell if a conspiracy is real. I mean, it's not perfect science. But it is a great way to tell if it holds water. And so when you look at the Kennedy assassination and you look at all the death that came after it, yeah, there's collusion here. There's something very wrong here. And the mafia is obviously involved. And I often wonder how Joe Kennedy felt knowing that you got your kids killed. You know, if you... it was your connections that got them to where they are. I mean, you could make the argument that they got themselves killed for fighting off and biting the very hand that fed them, but they were trying to bring a sign of transparency into our government, which would have changed the American dream forever because we would have had 16 years of Kennedy's being president. Think about that. Almost fucking 20 years of presidents named Kennedy. That's a dream come true. So if that hadn't happened, most likely Martin Luther King wouldn't have been fucking killed. I think King got killed in 64. Sam Cooke was killed because he was working with Martin Luther King. Elvis was a known CIA rat. There are, you know, movie stars were actually drug mules, not drug peddlers or drug dealers or any of that crazy shit, but they were mules. They carried confidential debt. They carried confidential, you know, files for different, parts of the government. They were literally stoolies for the government. And the reason why I really believe this is because Sam Cooke had literally gotten a phone call from Sammy Davis Jr. telling him to step the fuck back. And Sam Cooke told them to fuck off, you know, fuck you. No wonder you're called the Rat Pack, you fucking rat. And so, so 16 years of Kennedy presidencies would have changed everything in our outlook on secret societies and our outlook on conspiracies themselves, because he knew there were secret societies. He knew all that shit. And, the saying, the very idea of secrecy is repugnant, you know. So very clear that he knew what he was dealing with, and Kennedy definitely knew what was coming. And he had even, in certain ways, he had already called it out and predicted his own death. because he even said, well, if they want to get me, they'll get me. All it takes is a high-powered rifle and a roof. That's exactly what he said. That's all you need is a roof and a high-powered rifle. And so he always knew there was a target on his back. Or I guess on the side of his head. And so these are real heroes. These are the guys that face danger to change things for the better. Now, you want to see the very opposite, then we have ourselves a good segue into Alex Jones, shoot him! All right, so here comes Alex Jones talking some stupid-ass shit, because when you want to know what happens in the White House, yeah, ask Alex Jones, the guy that's not even allowed 50 feet near a Chuck E. Cheese.
The media going after Biden, and he deserves it, but they were covering it up until now. Now they're covering the laptop. Now they're covering attack on the dog. Now they're covering, you know, all of his senility, all the corruption, the Chinese spies.
Attacking a dog. What a pig he is. I'm sure.
That is the funniest part, because it is such bad acting from the squinting of the eyes to the leaning forward, pretending to be interested. I have to bring this up. I used to be a huge advocate for WeAreChange.com. We Are Change and the whole movement of We Are Change. I've gone ahead and thrown away my shirts. I've gone ahead and got rid of my my Guy Fawkes mask. I don't even have one. I lied about that. I would throw it away if I ever had one, but then again, I probably wouldn't, because they look cool, and my name is Guy, so, you know, and I'm named after Guy Fawkes. So I think I was kind of meant to be a rebellious motherfucker, because I'm literally named after one of the, you know, biggest activists of all time that was literally put on a stretcher to be tortured. And it took them, 3 to 5 days of torture just for him to say his name was Guy. It took him that long just for him to reveal that little bit of information. So, Guy Fawkes is an actual hero. So when we look at these guys who are the MAGA heroes, they are complete, utter fucking tools. They have no clue what they're talking about. Nothing but conspiracy theory. Not once will you ever hear Tucker Carlson say, do you mind if I ask, what is your source on that? You're never going to hear that, because he didn't give a fuck of it. You know, he knows it's all bullshit. And the fact that you have two guys talking about how awesome Trump is, and yet we know Tucker Carlson texts and talks shit about him behind his back. Then we have Alex Jones, who is on tape saying, I wish I never heard the fucking name Donald Trump. I wish I never fucking met that man. And here you are now. You seem to have a very different opinion while you were getting sued for the Sandy Hook issue. So it just, the fact that you can think that these guys give a fuck about anything is ridiculous. So what does that have to do with We Are Change? Well, when I wanted to go talk to some of my old friends from that group. I used to be a part of Anonymous with the actual political, you know, the actual protests I was there for police brutality, for investigation on 9/11, for the dungeons that we had in Chicago. May never have heard of that story, but we have actual dungeons, like they're these black sites, and so they're abandoned places that police will take you to in the South Side that you ain't coming out of. And a lot of police, especially if you live in LA, are gang members. They are their own gang. Blacks are not allowed in it. So there's multiple different gangs within the police system. And these are the type of subjects that should be covered. I mean, that's why I cover them. But you'll never hear from these motherfuckers. And that's how you know they're not telling you the truth. So when I go to We Are Change, just to kind of check in, the motherfucker is trying to hawk a Tucker Carlson 2024 shirt. This is the same man that went to the protests, that helped arrange these protests. I went to them. He led them. He was the cameraman in Loose Change for a lot of that shit. And you are literally going from neocon to full-on anti-Americans. I have lost all faith in We Are Change. I do not affiliate with myself with that group. I do not affiliate myself with Anonymous. I think that both of these groups have completely bastardized what it was about. It's a lot like the Republican and Democratic governing systems, how they originally were and what they became after the 1800s. And then during the 1900s, they did the full-on switch because Democrats allowed black representatives. And that's where they split and said, no, fuck you then. We're Republican. And so it was Republican that was the side of Lincoln. Don't ever forget that switched a long time ago when you guys were freaking out because they hired a black man. So, yeah. Thanks, Obama. Fucking douchebags. All right. So, fuck you, Tucker Carlson. That kills him, too. All right. So, I've killed off that. I've killed off Tucker. Killed off We Are Changed. Now, finally, I'm going to get into the Latino vote issue. And I think I can sum this up almost in one video. So let's go ahead and just air it and let you judge for yourself.
Vayas al demonio, Mr. Trump. Vayas al demonio, Mr. Trump.
¡Pasa! Estimado señor Donald Trump,
es un gusto conocerlo.
¿Cómo le va?
Buenas tardes, Mr. Trump. Yo creí en Norteamérica. Lo que no puedo creer es que en ese país haya personas como usted que no sean capaces de ver que si las personas van hacia su país es en busca de oportunidades, no en busca de hacer la misma destrucción que ellos mismos sufren en los lugares que dejan.
Su propuesta principal no es restablecer la economía, no es cubrir todos los problemas que tienen las personas en su país. Es racismo, es discriminación.
Me gustaría decirle que usted es una persona muy grosera.
Yo ahorita que lo tengo aquí enfrente, aunque sea un pedazo de cartón, a usted y a toda la clase que está explotando a los trabajadores norteamericanos y a los trabajadores mexicanos que está insultando, que insultó con lujo de detalle y que, sin embargo, es la gente que le da de tragar, que le da su fortuna.
Más que ofendido, tengo miedo de que usted llegue allá.
¿Cuántas personas no han trabajado indirecta o directamente por usted de origen latino, de origen mexicano?
Right there, that's a great
Igual
question.
Le hago la invitación a que venga.
That is a great question. I'm sorry, let's let it finish.
México, que más allá de sus desventajas, tiene gente que es muy buena y que tiene muchas cosas que ofrecer México.
All right, so that was the video. I did not want to speak over it because, if you don't speak Spanish, I don't expect everyone to speak Spanish, but I mean, there was just subtitles there. But that is a really great question to ask if he was really in front of you. How many of your fucking employees have been Latino that you either did not pay on the fucking table legally? And because in most cases, he used undocumented workers, so he was always paying immigrants under the table. But he would never let one fucking own any of his properties. He would never let one fucking live in his property properties, and they're not even his properties. They just have his name on it. So if you are Latino and you don't feel the way that they did in that video, watch the video again. Go back, go into Mexico. This is the same fucking piece of shit that wanted to go to war with Mexico. I got family in Mexico. I got friends in Mexico. You know, I'm not Mexican, but shit, everybody goes to Mexico. It's literally our neighbor. It's the number one fucking friend of America because we share that land now. You know, forget about the who owned what, the Alamo, this and that. We're beyond that. Now this is 2023. Let's move on. But we're never going to move on when we're constantly stuck with assholes that are dragging us back. All right. So Latinos, please don't ever forget you are Latino. We don't vote for fucking Trumps. All right. Fuck those Nazis. All right. And always remember, you Mexicans know what I'm talking about when I say fuck that puto. All right. So that's all the time I have for today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for checking us out. Please leave us a comment. Do you think Latinos should ever vote for Trump in any way, shape, or form? And don't you know, feel free to be as ruthless as possible down there, because I want to read some angry shit, man, because this really pisses me off, all right? I know I just ruined my great ending there, but, you know, fuck it. I'll just end it with a nice segue into nothing, then I shoot you. All right. Love you guys. Stay safe, stay free, and I will see you on the other side. Most of all, please stay cheesy, my friends. Always remember to stay a cheesy. All right, take it easy, guys.
Welcome to STS, brought to you by Useless Agent. This program is not meant to discredit anyone's social or sexual identity. You are all fair game in the eyes of the wicked, and we see you. Please grow a pair and enjoy. Or stick to Fox News. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
I would go out and rob some. More. We ran everything. We paid off cops. We paid off lawyers. We paid off judges. Everybody had their hands out. Everything was for the take. And now it's all over. Now it's all over. All over. All over. All over.
Welcome to Useless Agent.